Hi, this is Ricky Sun. I'm a Pi consultant. In this video, I'm going to talk about the Pi adapter for OPC UA because I wanted to connect to the OPC UA servers, and my options are from the old Aviva perspective. I cannot use Pi interface and I have to use the Pi connectors, which I talk about, and also the Pi adapters. So in the adapters, my take is my client doesn't like it because it is command line based. It's harder to support, it's harder to learn. I agree to it since we have to connect to the OPC UA servers, get the data. We have to evaluate all the options, and the only way to do that is to experience it. And now I am telling you my feedback on the Pi adapters for OPC UA. First, you look at my screen, and from this screen, that's the Pi adapters for OPC UA network architecture from my point of view. And first, I have a control network and with ignition system as well as OPC UA, and this is supported by another team. I have a new box for installing the Pi adapters for OPC UA in the same network, and then I was able to connect to it at discovery inside the command line. Easy, very easy. And then I was able to connect to it. And then these are the firewall between control network and the DMC is one of the challenge from my perspective, because I have to tell IT, hey, I need to submit HTTP requests from the Pi adapter servers to the Pi Web API on another network, which is in the DMC. So I need to ask IT to open port 443. So port 443 will be the only port you need to open to make adapters to work. I originally actually have a Pi Web API on the business network because we don't want to jump cross over from control network to business network. We decided to install Pi Web API on the DMC just to bypass a lot of documentation, because IT would not like us to bridge from control network all the way to business. That's why we do that architecture. And then the Pi Data Archive 5450, and then AF, right? Those should be already open, so you don't have to worry about that, because when you have interface, and they should already be open. And all you need to worry about is the adapters and the Pi Web API. If you like to make it high availability, you can make two adapters on the same network and also install a network load balancer with two Pi Web API. Then you can have achieved the high availability. So going back to the screen, after configure the adapters, here is my takeaway. The adapters have an edge command and it can do the configuration with edge command. We don't have to install edge command. That's a separate software, because I noticed we can use web API to send HTTP requests to the adapters for the configuration. So there's two ways to configure the adapters. You can use edge command with PowerShell or other tool like curl, which is in the manual, or from the postman, right? Like send a HTTP request to change the configuration inside the adapters. So two ways to do it, which way to go, up to you. Depends on which one you're more familiar. I would say there isn't that much documentation in the manual about the edge command. There is more documentation on the web API HTTP requests on how to configure the adapters. But you know, inside edge command, you can get help and all that. Then you get some examples there. So it is easier in both way, depends on your preference. Whatever, maybe harder for some, maybe easy or exciting for some of you, like Alex. He made the video on the Pi adapter for OPC UA. He's excited and he liked a command line, right? But you know, generally people doesn't like, especially when you do the support. It's just something to learn. may be harder to support in general. Just need some kind of special skill, maybe just a little bit of learning curve, but you know, someone who just jump in might not be able to know what is going on, to how to configure the adapters without too much knowledge, even to restart. The things that I like about the adapters is it has high availability. I mentioned before, it can do two adapters, and then you can configure cold, hot, or warm failover. Also, it can point to primary and the backup of the OPC UA server, so that's a great thing. Web API, you can do a load balancer and achieve HA for the adapters as well. And also backfilling. Backfilling is a major part for as an administrator. After we create a tag collecting data, we need to backfill the data, so it's all the data available for our user. It can do backfill, so it is better than connector in a way, because it can do the backfill. There's no way to do start time, end time backfilling, manual backfilling with the connectors, but with the adapters, you can create a new instance about it, so that's good. Not flexible on data discovery. And then I said no star. So, and I was playing with the data discovery inside the Pi adapters, and I wanted to only filter the data I wanted for tag creation. I want to only create pressure tags in multiple assets. It cannot do that. I have to manually create the pressure on multiple discovery. So that's the cons, because it's so hard to administration. It doesn't do auto discovery for multiple assets with the same kind of attributes. Then as a Pi administrator, going to be too hard to catch up with the other guy from the Ignition team. That is some work to be do, I think, to enhance it. But for now, we may just need to create a tag and then get the data, think about that later. Problem with that is no graphical user interface, and you cannot do AF as well. You can enable help point with the AF structure, but you cannot create AF structure from your data. Well, I guess for some it might be a problem, but for me, we just want to create a tag, so that might not be a problem. After create all these script, and then I was able to reuse those script again and again, like remove a discovery and re-edit and start and stop a component, that kind of thing. So it's not too bad from the scripting perspective to configure the interface from the Edge command. And I also try the REST API, and then it was able to achieve the same result. So, and follow along with the manual. Documentation wise, it's okay. I would like more examples. It might be great if you have more examples. To me, this is more flexible than the connectors, because I'm able to HA high availability and also backfilling, create multiple instances. But it just have cons about data discovery. It is pretty flexible in a sense, but you know, it's harder to support. I think a normal administrator need to take a course or spend some time on configuring the adapters in order to support it. It's not like you can jump and stop things and configure things on the fly. So I don't know, what do you think about the Pi adapters? This is my take, my personal opinion. It doesn't have to be yours. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, as well as hitting the bell icon. I'll see you next week. Bye.